today we're gonna take this chassis we built, and we're gonna add these shock towers. We're gonna have these drive shafts, links, and shocks, and maybe later we can fit the wheels. So let's get started. We're gonna start with the shock towers. They're both symmetrical, so it should just be a matter of so we're gonna take these small screws. If we're not, I'm just gonna I have no idea why they included one of these when it's a Phillips head, but okay. Let's try it like this. So, here we go. It's just a matter of adjusting these, maybe so that they're parallel or something. But let's continue. Let's pull this one out. So now we're gonna start with the drive shafts. You won't be needing this and this. We're gonna be needing these. So I managed to get it in. You're supposed to put it on the from the outside. Let's put the doubling here in position. Now we can attach this. So now we have the spinning drive shaft here. Let's do the rear ones the way it's supposed to do. Put that one in. Put this one. Little stump bone. Take one of these. Bit fiddly. I'm gonna have to extend these a little bit. And a new screw. Now these holes are very tight. So I had to put some different screws here. They're basically the same size, but a little bit better, and Allen key. So I guess I'll continue mounting the drive shafts and stuff. Now that's attached, we're gonna attach the steering arms. Starting stuff. So we just take a screwdriver here and try and hit the little. This is that. We can turn that to adjust the steering heading. Let's attach the second one. Now we have to do some adjustment to this. Oh well. So now we're gonna attach shocks. I haven't filled these with oil yet, but eventually I will. Should be fairly simple, just I don't have enough of these. Let's use one of those. Step. Now we can adjust these later, but for what it is, I think this is a good and the other two. Now I will fill these with oil later on. And then I will attach them with Loctite as you should. But for now, let me screw it in. So that I can unscrew it later. There we go. Two more of these black ones. So here we have that. Gonna grab a few things. We're gonna need this, and we're gonna be needing this, and a few other things. So now we're gonna start putting them in the, pushing in these pins. 12mm hex, the wheel itself. And why this didn't come with actual wheel nuts, I have no idea. But I had to steal them from the other car. But I have more coming. Why does this not go in? Well, when in that tiny bit of force works, yeah, that's this one. Oh, there we go. It's not quite complete. I need to mount a motor and a servo. Unfortunately, the servo banggood has been a little bit slow in shipping. So we'll see when that gets here. I got the motor. It's just mounted in a different car right now. I need to add some oil and a little receiver, and then this should be drivable. It, yeah, it spins. So just need to adjust these links. We still have this thing to add for the servo. There are these to add if we need it. Gonna find a suitable body for it. Otherwise, this build is done for at least a little while. We'll see if we're gonna upgrade. I have two motor mounts. But yeah. And see if we need to upgrade it later, because it's a little bit, but it should work. So this is this for this time, and maybe in not too short time, we can actually drive it, spin it around on the floor. Probably not outside, but you know, winter is what winter is, so. Next time, there's gonna be something fairly similar, actually. If you watch my shorts, so yeah. Until then, have a nice day.